It's devastating.
Allison Wells works for the local farm service agency. She says farmers are calling nonstop. Indre County farmer Derek Hughes says ponds have already dried up.
Cattle-wise, we're running out of water. The grass is dying, and we're getting ready to start having to haul some water to the cows.
And that's not the only issue these farmers face. With no water and extreme heat, grass isn't growing. And no grass means no hay.
We usually get two or three, maybe four on a good year, and this year we've got one cutting, and it's about half to a third of what it normally is.
Less hay leads to only one thing, hay costs tripling.
That's driving the price way up. Normally it's, you know, in between $30, $40 a bale, and this year it's up over $100.
This is hitting farmers where it hurts most, the pocketbook. Federal disaster relief funds may provide some money to local farmers, but in this case, it may not be enough.
Substantially compared to what they're up against on the cost to feed and take care of their animals, I'm sure it's going to be very minimal to what is really needed.
Farmers are optimistic people, though, and Mother Nature still has time to turn things around.
The point we do get rain, I mean, we're going to take every drop we can get, but for pastures and crops, I mean, it's little too late for it now, but we're still going to take it. We'll be blessed to have it and keep praying for it.